इवोल्यूशन एंड सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ लोकल गवर्नेंस। सो आई वुड
इसके
लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट डॉक्टर
इसके
हिमांशु शेखर मिश्रा सर टू टेक द सेशन।
एक्सक्यूज मी, अच्छा ये क्लास था कि जावा क्लास था जो प्रशांत कुमार दिखेन करो। हेलो,
हेलो, यस,
समथिंग देयर इज द क्लास ऑफ जावा बाय प्रशांत, वी आर साइबर सिक्योरिटी लर्नर्स।
नो 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 सर, इट्स ए डिसेंट्रलाइज एंड लोकल गवर्नेंस क्लास। इट्स ए मिक्स क्लास इन पॉलिटिकल साइंस एज वेल एज इन पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन।
No, but the code is sent to us, this code by OSAU. This class is
नो नो सर,
personal.
इट्स ए मिसकम्युनिकेशन हो।
No, but ball
चेक कर लेंगे
the
सर आउटर कोड।
अपना जितने लर्नर रहे सब तो साइबर सिक्योरिटी लर्नर रहे चंदे थे। हेलो,
हेलो,
हाँ ये जितने लर्नर हूँ देखो ये सब तो साइबर सिक्योरिटी देखो जी मुँह।
नहीं सर, एटे पॉलिटिकल साइंस एंड पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन रा पिला अछंती।
हेलो,
ओके, यस,
ना आम पाखे जो मिसमैचिंग कोड आसी ना FWUYXDEVWV এটা তো সাইবার
নাই নাই
সিকিউরিটি পার্সন কুমার দীক্ষিত ক্লাস আম পাখে আসছি।
নাই নাই স্যার, এটা হচ্ছে ডক্টর হিমাংশু শেখর মিশ্রা স্যারঙ্ক ক্লাস।
হ্যালো স্যার, প্রসন্ন কুমার দীক্ষিত স্যারঙ্কর আউ গোটে লিঙ্ক অছি, টিকে টিকে জাস্ট লিঙ্ক রে ডিফারেন্ট থিবো, আউ গোটে লিঙ্ক অছি সে লিঙ্ক রে ক্লিক কর দিয়ন্তু।
না মো পাখে যো লিঙ্ক টা আসছি মু সেই লিঙ্ক রে হি ক্লিক করলি। ମୁଁ କହୁଛି ଲିଙ୍କ ଆସିଛି ଏସଏମଏସ ରେ, ମୁଁ ସେଇ ଲିଙ୍କରେ କ୍ଲିକ୍ କରିଛି, ଦେଖନ୍ତୁ ଅନ୍ୟମାନେ ପ୍ଲେଟ୍ ହେଇକି ଆସୁଛନ୍ତି ନିଶାନ୍ତ ପୁରା ଏମଏନ ସବୁ କ'ଣ ମୁଁ କହୁଛି ସେଇ ଲିଙ୍କରେ
ନା
ଦେଖନ୍ତୁ କିଛି ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ କରିନି।
ଆମ ଷ୍ଟାଫ ସେ ସିଏସ ର ନୁହନ୍ତି, ସିଏ ଷ୍ଟାଫ ସେଇଥିପାଇଁ ସେ ଜଏନ କରିଛନ୍ତି।
ମୁଁ ତ ଦେଖୁ ସେଇ ଲିଙ୍କ
ଅଛି, ମୁଁ ଗୋଟେ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ ୱେଟ କରନ୍ତୁ, ମୋ ଲିଙ୍କଟା ପ୍ରସନ୍ନ କୁମାର ଦୀକ୍ଷିତଙ୍କ ଲିଙ୍କଟା ମୁଁ ଦେଖିକି ପଠେଇ ଦଉଛି, ଏଇଥିରେ ଆପଣ ସେଇଥିରେ କ୍ଲିକ୍ କରିଦେବେ ନହେଲେ।
ପଠାନ୍ତୁ ଏଥିରେ,
ସାର୍ ଗୋ ଆହେଡ୍।
ସୋ ଗୁଡ୍ ଆଫ୍ଟରନୁନ୍ ଟୁ ଅଲ୍। ଆଇ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ସି ଓନ୍ଲି 14 No, listeners are there. So, am I audible, Vignesh?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah?
You are audible, sir.
Okay. 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 Thank
yeah.
you. Thank you very much. So, today I'll be speaking on democratic decentralization concept, evolution, and significance. This is altogether a topic of a new course, and that course is all about public administration. And before I start, let me give some qualifying remarks. That last 12 to 13 years I have not read public administration, but I'm very much interested in this democratic decentralization, because that is related with democracy, and that's why I am just interested. But in the context of public administration, when we build, then I face a problem. The problem is that here we cannot interpret. Every term is a technical term. In every context, a term has a definite meaning. It cannot have more than one meaning. In contrast to public administration, in political theory, there is the possibility of interpretation. But since I am not the expert on public administration, I will use my interpretive power, and I will try to let you understand what I have understood. What is this democratic decentralization? Decentralization means what? Something which is not centralized. Something, you are bringing from the center and you are giving to the periphery. That is decentralization. What is democratic? Democratic means what? Or democracy means what? Democracy has many meaning. But in this context, understand democracy is planning, democracy is decision making, and democracy is administrative authority. So I said planning, decision making, and authority. What democracy or democratic in this context it means. So what is democratic decentralization? Now it means transfer of planning, decision making, administrative authority from central government to its field organization, local administrative units, semi-autonomous organization, local governments, and non-governmental organization. So let us understand what is this field organization. A field organization is a set of organization that in aggregate constitute a recognized area of institutional life, and it produces similar kind of services and product. We can take the example of superintendent of police office or the office of the collector. In every district, you will find there is a collector office, there is a office of superintendent of police. They are the field organization, right? Every district you will find this collector office and SP office, because they constitute an area of institutional life. And what is that institutional life? District administration. That is the institutional life. Every district has its own district administration, and every district has its own collector and SP. Right? And both collector and superintendent of police, they produce similar kind of services to the people. So collector and SP, they are the field, or they represent the field organization. What is local administrative units? We can take, you know, BDO, block developmental officer. He is the administrative head of a block. But every block has also its political head. So here local administrative units means that administrative head of the block, for example, BDO. Then semi-autonomous organization. What is semi-autonomous organization? Now semi-autonomous organization are those organizations which have a degree of self-government but not complete self-government. A degree of self-government but not complete self-government. In the context of public administration, I was thinking how to give an example of semi-autonomous organization, but I failed. Then I thought that let me give a general example of semi-autonomous organization. We can take the university as a semi-autonomous organization. How? On the financial matter, the university is not autonomous. But so far as internal administration is concerned, the university is an autonomous unit. So to some extent, the university has self-government. In some respect, it depends. It depends on state. It depends on university grant commission. So we can take university as a semi-autonomous organization. But this example may not fit in the context of public administration. You may think, and you may think of any other examples. Then there are local governments, Panchayat Raj. Local governments means Panchayat Raj system. Then there is non-governmental organization, NGO. Now this democratic decentralization, what I said, it is the transfer of planning, decision making, administrative authority from central government to the periphery, and periphery jo mu panchra jinsa kahili. How to have a clear understanding of democratic decentralization? Only when we can differentiate democratic decentralization from delegation, from administrative decentralization, and from democratic centralism. So when you will be clear about the difference between democratic decentralization and delegation, the difference between democratic decentralization and administrative decentralization, and the difference between democratic decentralization and the democratic centralism. So what is the difference between the democratic decentralization and delegation? Let us first take delegation. What is delegation? Now in delegation, there is a grant of authority from superior to subordinate. Jode higher authority achi, seta lower authority ko, kichi authority grant korichi, kichi authority deuchi. It is enjoyed not as a right. Subordinate ko jo authority miluchi, subordinate sei authority ko as a right rupare enjoy kari pariba nahi, but as a derived concession. That means the boss has given certain concession, and on that basis the subordinate is enjoying that right while performing the responsibility. It is exercised at the pleasure of superior. जेहेतु बॉस कंसेशन देइछि तनु तुमे बॉस रो मत विरुद्ध रे तमे एई राइट को एक्सरसाइज करि परिबो नाही, राइट? एंड दिस डेलीगेशन इट इज ए टेक्निक ऑफ डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन. डेलीगेशन इज ए टेक्निक ऑफ डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन, एंड delegation happens at the individual level, and there is no concept of freedom in delegation. There is only the concept of concession. That is delegation. What is decentralization? In contrast to delegation, what is democratic decentralization? Now in democratic decentralization, there is grant of authority from top level management to other level management. Ta mane ethi mu top level management byabohar kali aur other level management byabohar kali. Ar mane in democratic decentralization there is no concept of superior or subordinate. There is only the concept of top and bottom. When we are using top and bottom, then we don't understand bossism. We don't understand superior or inferior. I am not saying, when I am saying top management and bottom management, here I do not mean that top is superior, bottom is inferior. I am not saying that, and it doesn't mean that also. So in the democratic decentralization, there is a grant of authority from top level management to bottom level management. And here in this context, the bottom level management enjoys this as a right. not as a concession. माने जोंटा delegation ले जने right हिसाब रे व्यवहार करी पारु नथला democratic decentralization ले one can use it as a right. And in the democratic decentralization, it is the philosophy of decentralization. Delegation le mo kon kahili, it is the technique of decentralization. But here, democratic decentralization, it is the philosophy of decentralization. And it happens at the level of organization. At a organizational level nahi, democratic decentralization hai tha. Here, there is full freedom. ग्राम पंचायत को जो पावर टा मिलुची सेठी ग्राम पंचायत तर संपूर्ण अधिकार अच्छी तर संपूर्ण फ्रीडम अच्छी पॉलिसी को तैयारी करी परिबो पॉलिसी को एग्जीक्यूट करी परिबो इट हैज टोटल फ्रीडम इन द डेमोक्रेटिक डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन सो दैट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन डेलीगेशन एंड डेमोक्रेटिक डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन यदि गोटे पॉइंट रे कहिबा delegation le delegation happens at individual level and the individual do not have right delegation is not a right to that individual delegation is a you know it is a concession to that individual but in democratic decentralization it happens at the societal level and the society enjoys it as a right not as a concession now let's come to the difference between the democratic decentralization and administrative decentralization now what is administrative decentralization in administrative decentralization arises or originates with the need for efficiency and speed administrative personnel particularly at lower level it is a freedom to implement project that means administrative decentralization like kaunchi here you are not making the plan you are not designing the project rather than you are implementing the project you are not designing or making the project you don't have the power to plan but you are free to implement it right kahi ki aku implementation power ta kahi ki diya jai chi na for the cause of efficiency and speed administration kai ki diya jai chi na tar efficiency ku sie enrich kari paribo au tar administration ku tike speed up kari paribo sathi pai in administrative decentralization power has been given at the implementation at the implementation level right it is not at all related with planning it is not at all related with design right but on the other side the democratic decentralization it is something wider it envisages association of more and more people with the government at all levels it starts with people's right to initiate their own project in a autonomous manner democratic decentralization le lokomanankara they have the right and duty to plan for a project to design a project and to execute the project then ame kahi pariba that administrative decentralization it is one part of democratic decentralization is administrative decentralization and plus Now, let's come to the difference between the democratic decentralization and democratic centralism. What is democratic centralism? In democratic centralism, there is a combination of democracy with centralism. There is a transfer of authority from base to superstructure. Base is all powerful and superstructure must be democratic, centralism. Democratic kahiki? Na, there is a transfer of power. Power transfer eti hoji. Center ba base ba boss. Boss tara employee manku kichi power dauchi. Kintu power deisala pore. The boss is all powerful. Boss jaha kohibo, employee saya kohibo. The employee must have the total surrender or complete surrender to the boss. Tamane distribution hobo sethi. Base ru superstructure aduku distribution hobo. Transfer hobo, power transfer hobo. Kintu power transfer hela pore. The subordinate, ba ame joku kahiba, jonta bottom level administration. CA बेसी ता पाखरे कोनोसी पावर रहिबो नै से केवल तार वॉल्यूंटरी ओबिडियंस जो टका में कहबा कंप्लीट सरेंडर टू द बेस से बेस को मो फॉर एग्जांपल नौची बॉस से बॉस मते ही किछि पावर दउची बिकॉज आई एम द एम्प्लॉय ऑफ दैट बॉस मते किछि पावर दउची बट आफ्टर गेटिंग दैट पावर the boss becomes very powerful. The boss has the right to guide me, and the boss expect a voluntary obedience, what I call complete surrender to the boss. Tano democratic centralism re kon hauchi e jo transfer ta hauchi power, a power transfer dwara subordinate re kichi labha hauchi. जदि एटर लाभ होउछि केवल बॉस रे ही लाभ होउछि बॉस को गोटे पर्सन मिली जाउछि बॉस ताको किछि पावर दउछि आ जेहेतु बॉस ताको किछि पावर दउछि सेही पावर दबा आळ रे बॉस टी ता पाखरु कंप्लीट सरेंडर भी करै नउछि इट मेड सबोर्डिनेट टू शो द कंप्लीट सरेंडर टू द बॉस. In contrast, democratic decentralization, democratic principles finds a wider application. Local self-government is its institutionalized form. That means, top level management, bottom level management ko power deisala pore, the bottom level management becomes all powerful. There is no intervention from the top level management. But there are certain rules and regulations while making a project, while designing a project, while implementing a project. The bottom level management should not violate the principles or the guidelines that has been designed by top level management. We can take the example our gram panchayat system or gram sabha. Sarpanch ko pakko jaha kichhi bhi paisa patra asuchi corona samay re top level management ru jaha bhi kichhi paisa patra asuchi bolanta sarpanch collector. सरपंच ताको आर्बिट्रली खर्च करि परिबेनी बट सरपंच इज पावरफुल सरपंच को पावर दिया जाय छ बट सरपंच जतबेले ताको पावर को व्यवहार करुचंती सतबेले सरपंच किछि गाइडलाइंस ताको फॉलो करिबा पई पडिबो इफ यू आर फेलिंग टू फॉलो द गाइडलाइन then there will be some disciplinary action that will be taken against this branch. So from these differences, a difference between the democratic decentralization delegation, democratic decentralization and administrative decentralization, democratic decentralization and democratic centralism, one can have sense what democratic decentralization stands for. So if you look closely what this democratic decentralization is all about, then you may find that democratic decentralization is a strategy of bringing reforms in democracy. Democratic decentralization is a strategy of bringing reforms in democracy. That means if there is no decentralization, then it is not democracy. Arambharu amaro desa swadhinava pare ame state centric developmental development model ku follow karuchilu jeunthi state society ku direction dautila how to achieve the development, right? A dwara kon hela na democracy dekha gala jodi democracy ku impose kara jauchi society manko upore, then democracy is getting weakened. So it was realized that centralization is dangerous to democracy. Hence, there must be some reform. There must be some reform in democracy. And what is that reform? Now, decentralization is the reform. Through decentralization, or decentralization as a strategy, using decentralization as a strategy, some reform can be possible in democracy. Kahi ki reform darkar? The reform in democracy, it is necessary or needed in order to deepen the democracy, in order to make our democracy successful. And this decentralization as a strategy or as a reform, it leads to transparency, it leads to responsiveness, it leads to accountability, it leads to good governance. Transparency kona? Something which is crystal clear. Lokongo pai center ru 10 taka aschi kichi samay pai ame chinta kariba ame gute centralized system re achu 10 taka asila lokongo pai but lokongo pakare pahunchila bel ku se 10 taka ta 2 taka hei jau jodi ame taku khol tad karuchu sethi bibhinna kagacha patra madhyamare amku dekha jauchi ame 10 taka ku pahunchei chu county na county ame feel karuchu there is the problem of transparency. There is the problem of transparency. Decentralization hoba dwara kon hochi na the 10 rupees is coming to the village, and when it is reaching to the village, and when the villagers along with sarpanch they are utilizing it, then transparency gets managed, transparency gets maintained. Then the responsiveness. What is responsiveness? If there is a centralized system, then it creates passive individual. Passive individual or active individual bhitare parthakya kona? Now a passive individual is not responsive. A active individual, he gives response. It is responsive. Passive responsive, no? Active responsive. Then decentralization dwara, we got active citizen, active participation. When there is active citizen, active participation, then it leads to responsiveness. That means people are giving response. You know, without the response of individual, democracy cannot be worked out. Then accountability. When people are planning, people are designing, people are implementing the program, then they are accountable. Accountable means legally responsible. They have to show whether they have followed the rules or regulation or not, whether the means is justifying the end or not. So these are the things they must take the legal responsibility. If there is anything wrong, then one may sue the sarpanch in the court of law. So this decentralization, it leads to transparency, it leads to responsiveness, and it leads to accountability. This is also an appropriate mechanism to deal with the contemporary trend of liberalization, privatization, and globalization. एठी ए कॉन्टेक्स्ट रे लिबरलाइजेशन प्राइवेटाइजेशन और ग्लोबलाइजेशन ला माने कौन थिंग्स आर सो फास्ट वर्ल्ड इज मूविंग सो फास्ट नीड्स आर कंटिन्यूअसली एमर्जिंग इफ यू विल बी पैसिव देन सम प्रॉब्लम विल अराइज इन योर लाइफ इन योर personal and professional life. So centralization le kon hautila sabu jinsa guda delay hautila lokomanku se passive kare dautila jaha dwara ki government sector ete passive he jautila centralization le ki se liberalization privatization globalization jota ko kwa jauchi contemporary trend ए ट्रेंड सहित गवर्नमेंट फिट कर पार नथला आ फिट हो पार नथला बट डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन आसीबा परे यू नो पीपल आर बिकमिंग एक्टिव लोक माने एक्टिव हेले गवर्नमेंट भी सब जिनस को स्पीड अप करेला एंड दैट्स हाउ कंटेम्पोररी ट्रेंड सहित गवर्नमेंट भी पादरे पाद मिसेकी आग को बढ़िला. The purpose of democratic decentralization is widening the area of people's participation, people's authority, people's autonomy through the transfer of power to people's representative organization from top level to bottom level. Then democratic decentralization le jete bele lokomanko pakoku power asigala tebe dita jinsa eti hela. गोटे जिनस कौन ना जो कामटा दस दिन लगुला सेन्ट्रालाइजेसन से कमटा पांच दिन लेगला यहाँ गोटे है डेमोक्रेटिक डिसेंट्रलाइजेसन आउ गोटे एस्पेक्ट कौन है ना डेमोक्रेटिक डिसेंट्रलाइजेसन डेमोक्रेसी ये डीपली रूटेड है अल्टिमेटली लोक मैंने फिल करें कि दे और दे आर रिप्रेजेटेटिव they are doing something for them. Lokomane feel kari parile the democracy is of the people, by the people, and for the people. Eita lokomane feel kari parile. So as I said, The purpose of democratic decentralization is widening the area of people's participation, people's authority, people's autonomy through the transfer of power to people's representative organization from top level to bottom level in political decision making, financial control, administrative management with least interference of the higher level. Tamane ethi higher level lo konosi interference rahila nahi. Now let's move to evolution of democratic decentralization. So after the Second World War, say samay pakha pakhi bi amaro desa independence paitila, most of the newly nation state, they adopted the growth centered model system or the growth centered model for development, where the state took the moral and political responsibility for the development of the society. ଯେଉଁଟାକୁ ଆମେ କହିପାରିବୁ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରିକ୍ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ମଡେଲ ନା ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ଇମ୍ପୋଜ୍ ଇଟ୍ସ ଆଇଡିଏଲ୍ ଓଭର୍ ଦି ୟୁନୋ ଓଭର୍ ଦି ବଟମ୍ ଲେବୁଲ୍ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍ ନୋ ଡାଉଟ୍ ଡ୍ୟୁ ଟୁ ଦିସ୍ ଗ୍ରୋଥ୍ ସେଣ୍ଟର୍ଡ ମଡେଲ ଫର୍ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ GDP in the country, it increased, but it increased at greater social and environmental cost. Kon hela ethi? Now, what is the social cost and what is the environmental cost? Now, growth-centered model system re, ଏମାନେ ସବୁ ମନିଟାରୀ ମାଇଣ୍ଡସେଟରେ କନଭର୍ଟ ହେଇଗଲେ ନା ମନି କ୍ୟାନ୍ ବାଇ ଏଭ୍ରିଥିଂ ଏକୁମୁଲେସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ୱେଲ୍ଥ ୱେନ୍ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ନୋ ଲିମିଟେସନ୍ ଇନ୍ ୟୋର୍ ଏମ୍ବିସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏକୁମୁଲେଟିଂ ୱେଲ୍ଥ ଦେନ୍ ନୋ ଡାଉଟ୍ ଦ ଗ୍ରୋସ୍ ଡୋମେଷ୍ଟିକ୍ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ୟୋର୍ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରି ଇଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ଇନକ୍ରିଜ୍ ବଟ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଇନକ୍ରିଜିଂ at social and environmental cost. What is social cost? That there is disturbance in the family, relationship are in crisis, this monetary mindset, it gradually becomes the cause of the degradation of human quality within the individual. This is the social cost. And what is the environmental cost? That our greed of accumulation has endangered our environment. Environment, it was, you know, continuously degraded. And when environment degrades, then aji jaha hochi seiya hi hue jetole environment degradation kare setabele finally manisa ghare hi rahita luchiki hi rahita tenu amar jo gdp badhila jota growth centered model of for development ei karanaru amar gdp badhila kintu ଏଇ ଜି ଡି ପି ସୋସିଆଲ ଆଉ ଏନଭାରମେଣ୍ଟାଲ କଷ୍ଟ ଉପରେ ହିଁ ବଢ଼ିଲା ଆଇ ମିନ୍ ୱି ପେ ଦି କଷ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ରିଲେସନ୍ସିପ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏନଭାରମେଣ୍ଟ ୱାଇଲ୍ ମେକିଂ ଆୱାର ଜି ଡି ପି ଇନକ୍ରିଜ୍ଡ ସଚ୍ ମଡେଲ ବାଇପାସ୍ଡ ଲାର୍ଜ ସେକ୍ସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦି ସୋସାଇଟି ଆଣ୍ଡ ଲେଡ୍ ଟୁ ଗ୍ରେଟର ଡିସ୍ପାରିଟି ଆଣ୍ଡ ମାର୍ଜିନାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ନା ଯେତେବେଳେ ମନିଟାରୀ ମାଇଣ୍ଡସେଟ୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜେସନ୍ ଆଙ୍କର ଯେତେବେଳେ ମନିଟାରୀ ମାଇଣ୍ଡସେଟ୍ ଆସିଗଲା ତ ସେତେବେଳେ ଦେଖାଗଲା କ'ଣ ନା ଏଇ ଗ୍ରୋଥ୍ ସେଣ୍ଟର୍ ମଡେଲ ଫର୍ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ये सोसाइटी रो लार्ज सेक्शन, सोसाइटी रो लार्ज सेक्शन किए ना जो माने नॉन एलिट, जो माने पावरलेस और डिप्राइव्ड और मार्जिनलाइज सेक्शन, लार्ज सेक्शन को ए मॉडल बाईपास कला, ए मॉडल आंको पाई किछि करि परला नाही, केवल हायर मिडिल क्लास और बिजनेस क्लास को एटा एडवांटेज देला। इट रेज्ड डाउट्स रिगार्डिंग द अचीवमेंट ऑफ वेलफेयर ऑब्जेक्टिव सच एज रिमूवल ऑफ पॉवर्टी एंड सोशल इनइक्वालिटी एंड अचीवमेंट ऑफ इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ विथ सोशल जस्टिस। ना लोक डाउट करिबा आरंभ कले ए जो ग्रोथ सेंटर्ड मॉडल फॉर डेवलपमेंट को लोक डाउट कले, काहेकि ना आ द्वारा पॉवर्टी बढ़ुतिला, इनइक्वालिटी बढ़ुतिला, तेणु आमर डेमोक्रेसी रे जो वेलफेयर ऑब्जेक्टिव थिला डायरेक्टली ए ग्रोथ सेंटर्ड मॉडल ए सिस्टम टा आमर डेमोक्रेसी रे जो गोल थिला से गोल को डायरेक्ट हिटबैक करुतिला, राइट? कहीं ना एटा पॉवर्टी को बढ़ाउतिला, एटा इनइक्वालिटी को बढ़ाउतिला। डेमोक्रेसी रो अर्थ होची रिमूविंग दिस पॉवर्टी एंड इनइक्वालिटी। तो एटा गोटे प्रकार रो यू नो इट रेज डाउट रिगार्डिंग अचीवमेंट ऑफ वेलफेयर ऑब्जेक्टिव। आमर वेलफेयर ऑब्जेक्टिव कौन? टू रिमूव पॉवर्टी एंड टू रिमूव इनइक्वालिटी। तेणु डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन कौन कला ना डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन चाहिला कि ए जो पॉवर्टी आउ इनइक्वालिटी जोटा ग्रोथ सेंटर्ड मॉडल रु ही आसी रिमूव कर, आउ गोटे कौन कर ना अचीवमेंट ऑफ इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ विथ सोशल जस्टिस। तेणु डेमोक्रेसी दीटा जिनस को धरिकी चले, गोटे को धरे डेवलपमेंट इकोनॉमी जोटा को मु थियोरिटिकल कनसेप्ट कहले लिबर्टी कहे, लेट द इंडिविजुअल फ्री, गोटे लिबर्टी को धरे, आउ गोटे को इक्वालिटी धरे। आउ इक्वालिटी रा केमती मेंटेन हबो ना ओनली व्वेन यू गिव रेस्पेक्ट टू दि सोशल जस्टिस। तेणु कौन सी वेलफेयर स्टेट सीए लिबर्टी आउ इक्वालिटी रो डायलेक्टिकल रिलेशन अच्छी से डायलेक्टिकल रिलेशन उपरे से वेलफेयर स्टेट टी इट इज बेस्ड। सो एवरी वेलफेयर स्टेट इज बेस्ड ऑन ए डायलेक्टिकल रिलेशन बिटवीन द लिबर्टी एंड इक्वालिटी, राइट? So the centralized planning of such model was questioned during 1970s. तेणु 1950 रु 1970 पर्यंत आमर ग्रोथ सेंटर्ड मॉडल सिस्टम थिला। आउ 1960 रु 1970 भितरे आमर जो ग्रोथ सेंटर्ड मॉडल थिला जोटा सेंट्रलाइज्ड सिस्टम थिला, ए सिस्टम उपरे क्वेश्चन मार्क पुट हैला। एंड एट द सेम टाइम ए ग्रोइंग रियलाइजेशन अकर्ड एमंग पॉलिसी एनालिस्ट दैट इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू प्लान एंड एडमिनिस्टर ऑल डेवलपमेंटल एक्टिविटीज एक्टिवली एंड एफिशिएंटली फ्रॉम द सेंटर। ता माने सेंट्रलाइज सिस्टम को माने क्वेश्चन पुट कले, कारण सेंट्रलाइज सिस्टम रे सब प्रॉब्लम गुड़ा थिला। सही समय आमर पॉलिसी एनालिस्ट माने से भी चिंता करके देखिले कि आमर जेतिकी भी डेवलपमेंटल मॉडल सब अच्छी आम पाखे जेतिकी डेवलपमेंटल प्रोग्राम सब अच्छी ताकू आम सेंटर रु केबे भी केन्द्र रु सेंटर रु केबे भी आम इफेक्टिवली बा एफिशिएंटली आमे निजे भी जानिनु कि आमे जो जगार को इम्प्लीमेंट करिबा पई जाउचो से जगार नेचर कौन, से जगार जियोग्राफी कौन, से जगार इंडिविजुअल केमिति, से जगार एनवायरनमेंट कौन। तेणु प्रॉब्लम ऑफ हेट्रोजिनिटी इट वाज बिफोर देम। तेणु सेमाने ग्रेजुअली फील कले कौन कि सेंट्रलाइज सिस्टम रे जदि आमे डेवलपमेंटल पॉलिसी को आमे इम्प्लीमेंट करिबो तेबे आमे इफेक्टिवली आउ एफिशिएंटली ताकु आमे आई मीन इट कैन नॉट कंट्रीब्यूट टुवर्ड्स डेमोक्रेसी। एटा इफेक्टिवली आउ एफिशिएंटली हेई परिबोनी जदि एटा न हुए देन इट कैन नॉट कंट्रीब्यूट टू और क्वालिटेटिवली कंट्रीब्यूट टू democracy. Now, such realization of these, policy analysts, such realization revived the notion of decentralization, and they, invented participatory development. So instead of growth center model for development, they decided for participatory model of development. And this participatory model of development, it emerged as an agency of decentralization. Now it gives a new perspective, and as a new perspective, this participatory development model, it stressed on quality of life of individual, family and community along with economic growth. Then our participatory development model asila siya prathame dekhila kahako na se prathame dekhila the quality of life economy purboru growth center model dekhila economy ko, but participatory jo development model thila ye prathame dekhila the quality of life ko besi importance thila it is for family, it is for community. Ta sahito kahaku importance dela na ta sahito importance dela economic growth ko. Now this participatory development model, it holds that development can be sustained if special efforts are made systematically to involve the deprived section of the society and their special needs. Tano if you remember a class re no se democracy india democracy development class re mo prathama class re define karitili how democracy is related to development. There are two two ways to establish the relation between the democracy and development. One is the binary way, the other one is a dialectical way of interrelating democracy with the development. And without democracy, in the dialectical connection I said without democracy the development is also irrelevant. Ethi bhi sahi katha ta kuha jauchi ki jodi amaro deprived section loko mane democracy re part hei jodi samane hoi paru nahanti जदि से माने डेमोक्रेसी रे पार्ट हे करु नाहंती तबे डेवलपमेंट भी इररिलेवेंट हे जाउची. तणु डेवलपमेंट को सस्टेन केते बेले हे परिबो डेवलपमेंट ना जते बेले डिप्राइव्ड सेक्शन लो लोक माने दे विल इन्वॉल्व मोर इन नंबर जमिति कि हमें कहि परिबा विदाउट labor, your capital is meaningless. Samiti, deprived section mane, tanko pakare kon nahi, tanko pakare capital nahi. Aur jodi seman ku involve developmental project re nokara jaye, tebe development hei bi pariboni. Tenu development ba capital needs labor, and labor needs capital. That is the dialectical relation between the democracy and development. Now let's come to the significance of democratic decentralization. Mutako kichi point wise kari deichi, we'll discuss. Now democratic decentralization, it is the theory of development. When I am saying or connecting development with decentralization, then I am saying centralization leads to underdevelopment. ଯେଉଁଟା ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ 70s ରିଏଲାଇଜ୍ କରିଥିଲା ଇଫ୍ ଦି ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ବି ମୋର ସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜ୍ ଦେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଲିଡ୍ସ ଟୁ ଦି ଅଣ୍ଡର୍ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ କାହିଁକି ନା ହିୟର୍ ପିପୁଲ୍ ଦେ ବିକମ୍ ପେସିଭ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇନ୍ ଏ ଡେମୋକ୍ରେସି ଇଫ୍ ପିପୁଲ୍ ଆର୍ ପେସିଭ୍ then development also become passive. The development becomes irrelevant, meaningless. Decentralization le kon hauchi na people are they are responsive, they are accountable, right? And they are responsive, they are accountable. How to call it? So democratic decentralization, it is a theory of development. It is a theory of development. Development needs the active participation of the people. And decentralization gives that active participation. এইটা হচ্ছে তার ক্রক্স পয়েন্ট দেন দি সেকেন্ড ডেমোক্রেটিক ডিসেন্ট্রালাইজেশন ইট ইজ এ গ্লোবাল ফিনোমেনা এটা কাহিকি গ্লোবাল ফিনোমেনা ওয়াই অল কন্ট্রি অ্যাডপ্ট ইট বিকজ ডিসেন্ট্রালাইজেশন ইট ইজ পজিটিভ টুয়ার্ডস পিপল ইট ইজ পজিটিভ টুয়ার্ডস সোসাইটি ইট ইজ পজিটিভ towards economy, it is positive towards state. Tenu ete gura positive jinsa achi sethi pai all country the world they have adopted decentralization as a mode of governance in their system. That's why democratic decentralization is a global phenomenon. Means of empowerment and upliftment, right? Ta mane kono na centralization is all about disempowerment and downliftment. Opera ulta dauchi downliftment. Kahi ki decentralization empowerment au upliftment karauchi? Because everything is coming to the people. Jodi loko mane tanko nijo pai planning karuchanti, nijo pai preparation karuchanti, sei koriba bhitre, you know, they are also learning by doing. If you remember Gandhi, when they are doing and they are learning, it gives a kind of empowerment to them. Now they are getting 10 rupees. What comes from the top? ଏଠି ଆଉ ଦଲାଲ ମାନେ 10 ଟଙ୍କାକୁ 2 ଟଙ୍କା କରଉନାହାନ୍ତି ପୁରା 10 ଟଙ୍କାଟା ତାଙ୍କ ପାଖରେ ପହଞ୍ଚୁଛି ଯେହେତୁ 10 ଟଙ୍କା ତାଙ୍କ ପାଖରେ ପହଞ୍ଚୁଛି ତାଙ୍କର ଅପଲିଫ୍ଟମେଣ୍ଟଟା ନ୍ୟାଚୁରାଲି ହେଉଛି ନେକ୍ସଟ ଡେମୋକ୍ରାଟିକ୍ ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଲେସନ୍ ଦି ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ୍ ଅଫ୍ ହେଟେରୋଜିନିଟି ଆ ପୂର୍ବରୁ ବି ମୁଁ କହିଛି ଯଦି ଆମେ ଦେଖିବା ସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ରେ ଯେଉଁଟା ଆମ ପଲିସି ଆନାଲିଷ୍ଟ ମାନେ ଚିନ୍ତା କରିଥିଲେ 70s କି ଯଦି ଆମେ ସେଣ୍ଟରରୁ ବିଭିନ୍ନ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟାଲ ପଲିସିକୁ ଆମେ ଇମ୍ପ୍ଲିମେଣ୍ଟ କରୁଛୁ ଦେନ୍ ୱି ଆର୍ ଫେସିଂ ୱାନ୍ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦେଟ୍ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ୍ ଇଜ୍ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ୍ ଅଫ୍ ହେଟେରୋଜିନିଟି ନାଉ ଦେଟ୍ ୱାନ୍ ପଲିସି cannot be effectively and efficiently implemented in different area of India. Now decentralization hoba phalare tanko pakku jo kichi paisa gala semane tankaro social system tankaro environment anusare se paisa ko byabahar kariki tankaro necessity anusare semane पॉलिसी को प्लान फॉर्मुलेट आउ इम्प्लीमेंट करी थान ता द्वारा कौन हुए ना डेमोक्रेटिक डिसेंट्रलिज्म आमर प्रॉब्लम ऑफ हेट्रोजिनिटी जोंटा आमर पॉलिसी एनालिस्ट माने फेस करूथले सही प्रॉब्लम ऑफ हेट्रोजिनिटी को टिके कमी दे थाए। नेक्स्ट डेमोक्रेटिक डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन इट मेक द कॉन्टैक्ट ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफिशियल्स एंड लोकल पीपल पॉसिबल कौन हैला ना जतबले सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट आसिला सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट बा पंचायत राज सिस्टम जतबले आसिला सेतबले देखा गला कि गोटे ऑफिसर आ गोटे साधारण लोक भितरे गोटे कम्युनिकेशन हेई पारिला आगुरु लोकटे ऑफिसर को डरुथिला ऑफिसर माने हाई लेवल माने जोंटा में कहबा माने गोटे बड़ बड़ ईगो मेंटेन करुथिले समान प्रबल ईगो थिला आज भी ईगो अछि आज भी तुम्हें सोशल मीडिया रे देखिथिबो केमिति से वीडियो टे से प्रवासी ओडिया मान को कहुचि कि मु वीडियो तुमर अधिकार नहीं मते किछि कहबा पई मु चाहिले तुमको छेड़ा करै देबी आज भी से ईगो हमर ऑफिशियल्स मान को भितरे रहिछि जदि आज हम गुटे डेवलपमेंट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन कॉन्टेक्स्ट रे आमे आजि वी आर सिचुएटेड इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ डेवलपमेंट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन जदि आजिका कॉन्टेक्स्ट रे गोटे ऑफिशियल्स भितरे एतिकी ईगो रही पारुचि देन यू कैन इमेजिन एट 70s तांको भितरे ईगो केते नथिबो गोटे साधारण लोक गोटे गोटे ऑफिसर को ता माने ता निजर आवश्यक से ऑफिसर होचि तार आई मीन देयर माने कोन कहंति तांको तांको कहंति सरकारी सरकार माने सरा कोन कहंति देयर सर्वेंट फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट साइड राइट से माने अछंदी लोकंको पई किंतु से साधारण लोकटे से ऑफिसर को भेटी पर नथला डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन हबा फलरे आमे तांको भेटी पारलु आमे आम कथा कहि पारलु आमे अथॉरिटी को चैलेंज भी करि पारिलु राइट एक्चुअली सेंट्रलाइजेशन रे अथॉरिटी माने बहुत माने तांको पाखरे बहुत पावर था राइट यू कैन नॉट टॉक हिम सो ड्यू टू दिस डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन डेमोक्रेटिक डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन the contact of government official and local people it become possible then next it facilitates a greater penetration of national policies to remote places decentralization hoba phale kon hela na amar national policy jonta sadharan lokongo pai jo policy taiyari kara jaithila se policy ta जाई कि डायरेक्टली लोकों पाखे पहुंची पारा ये डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन हवा जो नेक्स्ट इट लीड्स टू ग्रेटर इक्विटी इन एलोकेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेस इक्विटी मीन्स इम्पार्शियलिटी राइट डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन हवा फल कौन है ना आमर जो रिसोर्सेस अच्छी आमर रिसोर्सेस एलोकेशन टा फेयरली हो पारा गोटे इम्पार्शियली आम रिसोर्स एलोकेशन हो पारा then democratic decentralization it develops the capacity of local institution centralization le kon hautala na local institution guda sabu decay mode ku palai jaitila kamo kon thula centralization le gram panchayat re ete kichi power nathila right but decentralization le kon hela na जो मानन को पाखरे पावर नथिला सेंट्रलाइजेशन ले सेई लोकल इंस्टीट्यूशन माने तांकर कैपेसिटी को डेवलप करिवा आरंभ करले नाउ द सरपंच इज बिहेविंग अ सरपंच हैज बीन गिवन द पावर ऑफ ए कलेक्टर नाउ द सरपंच इज मच मोर एक्टिव इन दिस कोविड 19 डेज हियर सरपंच मींस व्हाट सरपंच रिप्रेजेंट्स ए लोकल इंस्टीट्यूशन तेणु डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन हवा फल लोकल इंस्टीट्यूशन जहाँ को मुझे कहूँ सरपंच से मानकर capacity badhila. Now they feel that, I mean, they are the one who can, you know, make local administration efficient and effective. ତାଙ୍କୁ ଯେତେବେଳେ କିଛି ପାୱାରଟେ ମିଳିଲା ସଦାବେଳେ ପାୱାର ଲୋକମାନଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ଗୋଟେ ଆକ୍ଟିଭନେସ୍ ଆଣିଥାଏ ଇଫ୍ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ନୋ ପାୱାର ୱିଥ୍ ୟୁ ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ୱିଲ୍ ବିକମ୍ ପେସିଭ୍ ତେଣୁ ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ କ'ଣ କଲା ନା ଲୋକାଲ ଇନଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁସନ୍ ମାନଙ୍କୁ ପାଖକୁ କିଛି ପାୱାର ହେଇକି ତାଙ୍କର କେପାସିଟି ଯେଉଁଟା ଡିକେ ହେଇଯାଉଥିଲା ଯେଉଁଟା ସରିଯାଉଥିଲା ସେ ସବୁ ଜିନିଷ ଗୁଡ଼ା ପୁନଃ ଉଦ୍ଧାର ହେଲା ମାନେ ସେ ଲୋକାଲ ଇନଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁସନ୍ ର କେପାସିଟି ବଢ଼ିଲା ଦେନ୍ ନେକ୍ସଟ ଇଟ୍ ରିଲିଭ୍ସ ଟପ୍ ମ୍ୟାନେଜମେଣ୍ଟ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଦେୟାର ରୁଟିନ୍ ଜବ୍ ସୋ ଦେଟ୍ ଦେ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଡିଭୋଟ୍ ଟାଇମ୍ ଟୁ ମୋର୍ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ଜବ୍ ନା ସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ରେ କ'ଣ ହଉଥିଲା ନା ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ଅଫିସିଆଲ୍ସ ମାନେ ସେମାନେ ତାଙ୍କର କ୍ରିଏଟିଭିଟିକୁ ହରାଉଥିଲେ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ଥିଲା ସେ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ଅନୁସାରେ ଗୋଟେ ରୁଟିନ୍ ୱାର୍କ ତାଙ୍କୁ କରିବା ପାଇଁ ପଡ଼ୁଥିଲା ବଟ୍ ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ରେ ତାଙ୍କୁ ସେ ରୁଟିନ୍ ୱାର୍କ କରିବା ପାଇଁ ପଡ଼ିଲାନି ସେ କାମ ଗୁଡ଼ା ଲୋକଙ୍କ ପାଖକୁ ପଳାଇଗଲା ଲୋକମାନେ ସେଇ କାମକୁ ୟୁନୋ ଆଇ ମିନ୍ ସେ ରୁଟିନ୍ ଜବ୍କୁ ଗ୍ରାଉଣ୍ଡ ଲେବୁଲ୍ରେ ୟୁନୋ ଦେ ଡୁ ଇଟ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦେଟ୍ସ ହାଓ ଦିସ୍ ଟପ୍ ଅଫିସିଆଲ୍ସ ଅର୍ ଟପ୍ ମ୍ୟାନେଜମେଣ୍ଟ ସେମାନେ ଏ ରୁଟିନ୍ ୱାର୍କରୁ ରିଲିଫ୍ ପାଇଲେ ଆଉ ସେମାନେ କ'ଣ କଲେ ନା ଦେ ଡିଭୋଟ୍ ଦେୟାର ଟାଇମ୍ ଇନ୍ ସମ୍ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ୱାର୍କସ୍ ଦ ନେକ୍ସଟ ଇଟ୍ ଇନଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁସନାଲାଇଜେସ୍ ଦି ପାର୍ଟିସିପେସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ସିଟିଜେନ୍ ଇନଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁସନାଲାଇଜେସ୍ ମିନ୍ସ ୱାଟ୍ ନା ପଞ୍ଚାୟତ ରାଜକୁ 73rd ଆଉ 24 ଆମେଣ୍ଡମେଣ୍ଟରେ କନଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁସନ୍ରେ ପାର୍ଟ କରାଗଲା ଗ୍ରାମସଭାକୁ ଲିଗାଲାଇଜ୍ କରାଗଲା ଗ୍ରାମସଭା ତା ନିଜର ଲେଜିଟିମାସି ରେସନାଲ୍ ଲିଗାଲ୍ ଅଥରିଟିରୁ ଡିରାଇଭ୍ କଲା ତାଦ୍ୱାରା କ'ଣ ହେଲା ନା ସିଟିଜେନ୍ସ ମାନେ ପାର୍ଟିସିପେଟ୍ କଲେ ଆଉ ସେଇ ପାର୍ଟିସିପେସନ୍ଟାକୁ ୟୁନୋ 73rd ଆଉ 74th ଆମେଣ୍ଡମେଣ୍ଟରେ ତାକୁ ଇନଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁସନାଲାଇଜ୍ ବି କରାଗଲା ଦେ ନେକ୍ସଟ ଇଟ୍ ଇନକ୍ରିଜେସ୍ ପଲିଟିକାଲ ଷ୍ଟାବିଲିଟି ଇଟ୍ ଇନକ୍ରିଜେସ୍ ପଲିଟିକାଲ ଷ୍ଟାବିଲିଟି ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ମିନ୍ସ ଡେମୋକ୍ରାଟିକ୍ ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ଦ୍ୱାରା ଷ୍ଟାବିଲିଟି ମେଣ୍ଟେନ୍ ହେଲା ଆଣ୍ଡ ହାଉ ଏ ଷ୍ଟାବିଲିଟିଟା କେମିତି ମେଣ୍ଟେନ୍ ହେଲା ନା ଡେମୋକ୍ରାଟିକ୍ ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ସିଏ ଡାଇଭର୍ସିଟି ଅଫ୍ ୟୁନିଟିକୁ ଆଧାରିତ କଲା ନଟ୍ ୟୁନିଟି ଇନ୍ ଡାଇଭର୍ସିଟି ଡାଇଭର୍ସିଟି ଅଫ୍ ୟୁନିଟି ମାନେ କ'ଣ ନା ଏଠି ଲୋକମାନେ ତାଙ୍କ ବିଭିନ୍ନତା ଅନୁସାରେ ବଞ୍ଚିବା ଆରମ୍ଭ କଲେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଲୋକମାନେ ତାଙ୍କ ନିଜର ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲିଟିକୁ ହରେଇଲେନି ହ୍ୱେନ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ ଡିଡ୍ ନଟ୍ ଫେସ୍ ଏନି କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ଏଲିଏନେସନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଲିଭ୍ ୱିଥ୍ ହିଜ୍ ଡାଇଭର୍ସ ପଲିଟିକୋ ସୋସିଓ ଇକୋନମିକ ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟେନ୍ସ ଦେନ୍ ସୋସାଇଟିରେ ଆଉ କେଓସ୍ନେସ୍ ବଢ଼ିଲାନି ସୋସାଇଟିରେ ଆଉ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ହେଲା ନାହିଁ ଆଣ୍ଡ ସୋସାଇଟି ଅର୍ ଦି ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ମୁଭ୍ସ ଟୁୱାର୍ଡ଼ସ୍ ଏ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ଷ୍ଟାବିଲିଟି ରାଇଟ୍ ଦେନ୍ ଦି ନେକ୍ସଟ ଇଟ୍ ମେକ୍ସ ରିପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେଟିଭ୍ ଡେମୋକ୍ରେସି ପସିବଲ୍ ନା ଦିସ୍ ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ଡେମୋକ୍ରେଟିକ୍ ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ଇଏ କ'ଣ କଲା ନା ଆମର ଯେଉଁ ରିପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେଟିଭ୍ ଡେମୋକ୍ରେସି ଅଛି ସେଇ ରିପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେଟିଭ୍ ଡେମୋକ୍ରେସିକୁ ଆକ୍ଚୁଆଲି ପ୍ରାକ୍ଟିକାଲ ସେନ୍ସରେ ତାକୁ ସେ କ'ଣ କଲା ନା ଇନଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁସନାଲାଇଜ୍ କଲା ନଟ୍ ଇନଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁସନାଲାଇଜ୍ ଆକ୍ଚୁଆଲି ଇଟ୍ ମେକ୍ସ ଆୱାର ରିପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେଟିଭ୍ ଡେମୋକ୍ରାସି ପସିବଲ୍ ରିପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେଟିଭ୍ ଡେମୋକ୍ରାସି ଯେଉଁଟା ଥିଓରିରେ ଥିଲା ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ଦ୍ୱାରା ସେଇ ରିପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେଟିଭ୍ ଡେମୋକ୍ରାସିଟା ପ୍ରାକ୍ଟିସ୍ରେ ବି ରିଫ୍ଲେକ୍ଟେଡ୍ ହେଲା ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦି ଲାଷ୍ଟ ପଏଣ୍ଟ ଲାଷ୍ଟ ସିଗ୍ନିଫିକାନ୍ସ ଇଜ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଡେମୋକ୍ରାଟିକ୍ ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଏନେବଲ୍ ପିପୁଲ୍ ଟୁ ଟେକ୍ ପାର୍ଟ ଇନ୍ ଦି ପଲିଟିକ୍ସ ନା ଲୋକମାନେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆକ୍ଟିଭଲି ପାର୍ଟିସିପେଟ୍ କରିବା ଆରମ୍ଭ କଲେ ଡ୍ୟୁ ଟୁ ଦିସ୍ ଡେମୋକ୍ରାଟିକ୍ ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ନାଉ ଏଭ୍ରି ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ ବିକମ୍ସ ପଲିଟିକାଲ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଏଭ୍ରି ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ ଅଣ୍ଡରଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡ ଦି ଏସେନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ପଲିଟିକ୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ ହ୍ୱେନ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ ବିକମ୍ସ ପଲିଟିକାଲ୍ ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ନୋ ଦିସ୍ ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ଏନେବଲ୍ ଦି ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ ଟୁ ଟେକ୍ ପାର୍ଟ in the politics. That's how, you know, due to this decentralization or democratic decentralization, we can say that identity politics or social movement, it got a very strong root. Jadi centralization hei thanta, tebe hue ta amaro identity politics ba amaro jetiki social movement segura ete ete matra re strengthen hei parinathanta, ete matra re samna ku asi parinathanta. But it is because of this democratic decentralization, because of when the marginalized section, they are involved in policy making, formulating, designing, implementing, they become political, right? They, you know, came to know the meaning, nature, and scope of politics. And once they know the politics, then they jump into the politics and they started doing the identity politics. They started doing many kinds of social movements, right? So in India, the Panchayat Raj system is an Indian way of decentralization. If you you know, go through the 73rd and 74th constitutional amendment, these two constitutional amendment has been a major step towards the decentralization process. The 73rd amendment is all about the rural local body, and 74th constitutional amendment is all about reforms in the urban local body. Mu ei 73rd 74th amendment bhitar ko jibi nahi, you can take any book, you can read ki what are the steps of decentralization that has been taken in the 73rd constitutional amendment, and at the rural level or rural society, and what are the decentralization rules, regulation or process that has been taken in the 74th amendment that is related with the reforms of urban local body. You can take any textbook, you can read, you can understand. There is nothing to make you understand on those point, right? There is Balwant Mehta committee, there is Mandal system, everything is there, right? You only to read and to understand it, right? So these two acts integrates 73rd or 74th constitutional amendment. These two acts integrates people's participation in a formal way with planning, with the planning process on one hand, and the devolution of responsibility to the people to the people themselves on the other, right? Tanu, these acts have addressed the persistent problem of irregular election, suppression, inadequate representation, lack of administrative financial autonomy, and inadequate resources. Then we 73rd or 74th amaro constitutional amendment hela jounti amaro you know rural local body or urban local body re ame ja kichi reform anilu ei amendment act dwara, ta dwara kon hela na you know the problem of irregular election. Irregular election kon na tumhe jodi mone pakaibo jetole centralism jodi rahibo, centralism jodi rahibo setebale tumhe mone pakaibo, you know, election ra due time re hobani, election ra situation dekhi ki ta time ko change kar diya hobo. There will be, you know, if there is centralism, then there is irregularities in election. You can remember Indira Gandhi, she kemiti sei samaro centralism thila. Indira Gandhi kemiti election ko kemiti manipulate korthile. Now decentralization hoba phalare kon hela na sei irregularities jonta election re jo irregularities houtila sei problem of irregularities ko decentralization address kala, au loko mane jo suppress sei ki rahi jauthile, loko mane passive houtile, sei problem of passiveness aku bi decentralization address kala. Decentralization how kon kala na amar jo representative democracy jo ta amar theory re thila, ସେଟା ଆମେ କେବଳ କହୁଥିଲୁ କି ଏଟା କେବଳ ଥିଓରିରେ ଅଛି, ପ୍ରାକ୍ଟିସରେ ନାହିଁ, ବଟ୍ ଆମର ୟୁନୋ ଡେମୋକ୍ରେଟିକ୍ ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ହେବା ଫଳରେ ଆମର ଆକ୍ଚୁଆଲ୍ ରିପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେସନ୍ ମାନେ ଆରମ୍ଭ ହେଲା, ବା ପିପୁଲ୍ ଷ୍ଟାର୍ଟେଡ୍ ରିଏଲାଇଜିଂ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ରିପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେଟିଭ୍ ଡେମୋକ୍ରେସି, ଲୋକମାନେ ନିଜେ ସେଠାରେ ଟେକ୍ ପାର୍ଟ କଲେ, ଲୋକମାନେ ତାଙ୍କ ରିପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେଟିଭ୍କୁ ଯାଇକି ସବୁ କଥା ଜଣେଇଲେ, ନାଓ ଦିଜ୍ ରିପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେଟିଭ୍ ବିକମ୍ସ ଭେରି ପାୱାରଫୁଲ୍, ସରପଞ୍ଚ ପାୱାରଫୁଲ୍ ହେଲା, ଏମ୍ଏଲ୍ଏଟେ ପାୱାରଫୁଲ୍ ହେଲା, ବଟ୍ ସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ରେ କେଉଁମାନେ ପାୱାରଫୁଲ୍ ନା, ସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ରେ ଦ ଆଡମିନିଷ୍ଟ୍ରେଟିଭ୍ ହେଡ୍ ଇଜ୍ ପାୱାରଫୁଲ୍, ନଟ୍ ଦି ପଲିଟିକାଲ୍ ହେଡ୍, ବଟ୍ ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ରେ କିଏ ପାୱାରଫୁଲ୍ ନା, ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ପଲିଟିକାଲ୍ ହେଡ୍ ହୁ ଇଜ୍ ପାୱାରଫୁଲ୍, ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ରିପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେଟିଭ୍ ଅଫ୍ ପିପୁଲ୍ ହୁ ଇଜ୍ ପାୱାରଫୁଲ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦି ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍, ବଟ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦି ସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ଅଫିସିଆଲ୍ ହୁ ଇଜ୍ ପାୱାରଫୁଲ୍. ଦେନ୍ ଲ୍ୟାକ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଆଡମିନିଷ୍ଟ୍ରେଟିଭ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ୍ ଫିନାନ୍ସିଆଲ୍ ଅଟୋନମି, ରାଇଟ୍? ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ରେ ଯେହେତୁ ସବୁ ଜିନିଷ ଗାଁକୁ ପଳେଇ ଆସିଲା, ସବୁ ଜିନିଷ ଲୋକଙ୍କ ପାଖକୁ ପହଞ୍ଚିଗଲା, ଲୋକମାନେ ଆଡମିନିଷ୍ଟ୍ରେଟିଭ୍ ଆଉ ଫିନାନ୍ସିଆଲ୍ ଇଏରେ ନିଜେ ଡିସିସନ୍ ନେଲେ, ନିଜେ ଏକ୍ଜିକ୍ୟୁଟ୍ କଲେ, ତେଣୁ ସେମାନେ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାରର ଆଡମିନିଷ୍ଟ୍ରେଟିଭ୍ ଆଉ ଫିନାନ୍ସିଆଲ୍ ଅଟୋନମିକୁ ଫିଲ୍ କରିବା ଆରମ୍ଭ କଲେ. ଆଉ ଏ ଫିଲିଂଟା କାହିଁକି ପସିବୁଲ୍ ହେଲା? ଏ ଫିଲିଂଟା ପସିବୁଲ୍ ହେଲା ଡେମୋକ୍ରେଟିକ୍ ଡିସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ଯୋଗୁଁ, ରାଇଟ୍? ଦେନ୍ ଇନ୍ଆଡିକୁଏଟ୍ ରିସୋର୍ସେସ୍, ନା ଯେହେତୁ 10 ଟଙ୍କାଟା ଯଦି 2 ଟଙ୍କା ମିଳିବ, ଦେନ୍ ପିପୁଲ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ସେ ଦେଟ୍ ଦିସ୍ 2 ରୁପିଜ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଆଡିକୁଏଟ୍. ତେଣୁ ସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲାଇଜେସନ୍ରେ କ'ଣ ହେଉଥିଲା ନା, ଯେଉଁଗୁଡ଼ା ଅଫିସର୍ ଥ୍ରୁରେ ଯେଉଁଟା ଆସୁଥିଲା, 10 ଟଙ୍କାଟା ଆସିକି 2 ଟଙ୍କାରେ ହିଁ ପହଞ୍ଚି ଯାଉଥିଲା, ତେଣୁ ସେ 2 ରୁପିଜ୍ ୱାଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଆଡିକୁଏଟ୍ ଫର୍ ଦେଟ୍ ଭିଲେଜ୍. But now the village is getting 10 out of 10, and that's how you know the 10 rupees becomes adequate for that village. So the problem of inadequate resources, eita ko bi amaro you know democratic decentralization to large extent it has been successful in dealing with all these. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Hello, sir, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Thank you, sir. You explain elaborately the concept of democratic decentralization. Also, you explain the evolution of a democratic decentralization from the colonial period to the Second World War, then to the contemporary period. Also, you explain briefly the significance of democratic decentralization. Thank you, sir. We have 7-8 questions. Out of 7-8 questions, I just read out the important, those are the important questions. Okay, sir?
Yes, please.
Okay, sir. Sir, the first question is, how can we investigate democracy and decentralization in terms of partition of the people? Sorry, participation of the people. How can we
investigate?
Yes, sir.
Yes. How democracy can we investigate?
Democracy and develop decentralization.
Democracy and decentralization.
In terms of participation of the people. Then, sir, the next question is, yes, sir, next question is, do you think due to democratic decentralization, it led more political as well as administrative,
Administrative
corruption in our system.
Yes. Tapre?
Then, sir, can we say the states of our country as a semi-autonomous?
Can we say
the states of our country? The states. Of our country
हाँ
आज है सेमी ऑटोनोमस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और इंस्टीट्यूशंस।
और इंस्टीट्यूशन हाँ
यस देन द सर फोर्थ
हाँ
क्वेश्चन इज व्हाई वी कुड नॉट हैव रीच्ड
हाँ
एट सोशल डेमोक्रेसी
रीच्ड अ सोशल डेमोक्रेसी
हाँ एट
हाँ
सोशल डेमोक्रेसी इन पंचायत लेवल बिकॉज इट इज द फाउंडेशन ऑफ डेमोक्रेटिक डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन।
बुझे बुझे बस ठीक है। हाँ
ओके
क्वेश्चन नंबर
सर
फाइव
सर what are the benefits of decentralization? I think sir you explain briefly in the class, I hope.
All the answers are already there.
Yes, yes. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you. So how can we investigate democracy and decentralization in terms of participation of the people? Right? Let me understand this question first. How can we investigate democracy and decentralization in terms of participation of the people? I mean, this is a very methodological question. If you understand the true nature of this question, how can we investigate? You can investigate only by doing social research. You can investigate by taking various kinds of research methodology and try to see how decentralization is related with the democracy, how decentralization is adding the democratic values to democracy. Now, democracy basically means that it is people-centric, right? I mean, chonda kohche by the people, for the people, of the people. Now, the decentralization in its theory, decentralization in theory, it is only about people. It is only about people. Now, without people participation, the decentralization cannot be possible. Now, once you are executing the decentralization, then you simply cannot say that people are not given the power or people are not getting the chance to participate in the politics, in the administration. Now, jodi ei jinsa ta bi houchi ki decentralization hoba pore bi jodi lokomane participate kori parunahanti, then what is the reason, right? Question number 4 bhi sei prashna ta pacharuchi that why we could not have reached at social democracy in the panchayat level. Na amar to decentralization hela panchayat system panchayat raj system arambha hela kintu ta pore bhi ame aji porjanto kahi ki social democracy mane kon mane jo ta amar ambedkar bujhutile sei ta kahi ei jo amar caste related thing ei ta hi mean karuchi कि आमर डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन हवा परे भी आज भी आम भितर कास्ट ये सब जिनस गुड़ा कहीं अच्छी ना इट प्राइमेली आर रीजन कारण कास्ट बा सोशल डेमोक्रेसी इट इज समथिंग डिफरेंट फ्रॉम यू नो डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन इन द डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन यू कैन एंजॉय द स्टेट पावर राइट आई मीन इफ यू आर हैविंग ए कंप्लेंट दैट that I am not feeling that is my government, I am not feeling that the government that is making a policy for me, I am not feeling that policy is related to me, that is not a policy of mine, right? In decentralization basically we try to enjoy the state power. We get a opportunity to become the agent of state and to make certain, you know, welfare activities or welfare work for us. तमाने आमे निजे ही प्लान करू, प्रोग्राम करू, डिजाइन करू, फॉर्मुलेट करू, इम्प्लीमेंट करू, आमे सब निजे ही करू. केवल गवर्नमेंट आमको फंडिंग दे थाए और आमको किसी गाइडलाइंस को फॉलो करिबा पई पड़े. सही टा डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन ल माने. किंतु जदि आमे कहिबा कि डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन हवा फल रे जदि हमरो सोशल डेमोक्रेसी नहि परुची, देन आई विल टेल दैट द डी कौन सटा डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन is not directly related with the social democracy, because social democracy in Ambedkar sense, it means that you know, problem of caste and the practice of untouchability. Now this caste and untouchability, these are a kind of mentality, and this mentality is not a simple mentality, right? So you cannot, you know, bring social democracy through decentralization. For achieving social democracy, I think decentralization is not at all, you know, related with the social democracy. And to have social democracy, we need to understand the self and the other in a Hegelian sense, right? Why caste is still there, right? We need to put this question and think about it. Why caste is still there? Right? Can we say democracy, or can we talk about democracy with the presence of caste and untouchability? Can we say that since you know, in India the maximum are Hindu, and they practice untouchability, so India is not a democratic country? Can we reach such kind of conclusion? So I think we have to understand that graded inequality and the complexity of caste system in order to deal with the problem of social democracy in India. So it has nothing to do with you know, decentralization. Decentralization is all about enjoying the state power at the local level, that is decentralization. So tanu first au char number question lo uttar ta deli. Then second question, do you think development decentralization, it led more political as well as administrative corruption into the system? Theoretically, no. I mean, decentralization hai ki corruption ko avoid kariba pai, especially administrative corruption ko avoid kariba pai. Kin jodi political corruption hochi, jodi tuma sarpanch politics karuchi, then sarpanch ko bachitiba loko mane hi problematic achanti. Ba जो सोसाइटी रे सही भलिया करप्टेड सरपंच कौनसी पॉलिसी को एग्जीक्यूट बा फॉर्मुलेट करूची से सोसाइटी टा गोटे वीक सोसाइटी. नाउ यू आर आल्सो रिस्पांसिबल फॉर द इमर्जेंस ऑफ दैट वीक सोसाइटी. तनो प्रथमे यू नो यू हैव टू मेक योर सोसाइटी वेरी स्ट्रांग वेरी सॉलिड, देन ओनली यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट योर सरपंच नॉट टू बी करप्टेड, राइट? सो आई विल ब्लेम द इंडिविजुअल, because individuals are mostly responsible for the emergence of a weak you know, society or community. And when society becomes or community becomes weak, then its leader becomes corrupt, right? So I may agree with you that even today in the panchayat raj system also, political corruptions are also been part. And our main reason, we cannot defy decentralization for that. I think we should defy our weak society, we should defy our corrupted society, and we should defy our passiveness. We should be very, very active in order to, you know, bring an ideal society, and that ideal or the good society that may produce a non-corrupt politician, and that non-corrupt politician will make successful the 73rd constitutional amendment and make our decentralization you know, successful, and it adds values to the democracy. Then question number 3, can we say the state of our country is semi autonomous organization? Kon eta padhila uthare? Hello,
sir, can we say, the states of our country आज ए सेमी ऑटोनोमस ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस और इंस्टीट्यूशंस
और इंस्टीट्यूशन हाँ यस यस वी कैन से दैट यस वी कैन से दैट द स्टेट इज ए सेमी ऑटोनोमस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और इंस्टीट्यूशन बिकॉज स्टेट इज नॉट कंप्लीटली फ्री फ्रॉम द सेंटर बट एट द सेम टाइम सेंटर हैज नो 100% and I'm thankful movie 80 gote byabahar kartili maybe one of my student has helped me semi autonomous organization right we can say that these are all contextual when center is there then the state is a semi autonomous institution jetabale state rahichi setabale university is a semi or district administration is a semi autonomous institution right semi autonomous institution mane kon कि तुम्हार किसी ऑटोनॉमी अच्छे बट दैट ऑटोनॉमी इज नॉट 100% देन द लास्ट क्वेश्चन व्हाट आर द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन आपको मैं रिपीट करी बिकॉज आई हैव ऑलरेडी सेड दैट डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन इन थियोरी इट इज ऑल अबाउट बेनिफिट्स बेनिफिट्स एंड बेनिफिट्स देयर इज नो लॉस बट इन प्रैक्टिस डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन इज नॉट बिकमिंग फ्रूटफुल व्हाट इट इज एक्सपेक्टेड समवेयर we people and the society what we are creating through our thought and action that is responsible for that I think theory is very good theory of decentralization is fine but we have to make it you know good or better okay thank you
I think sir one more question yes. One question from what is the difference between deconcentration and decentralization
deconcentration and decentralization
yes sir and one question is Suryakant Swami which year PR started in our Odisha I think 26 January 1961 I'm not sure sir
movie public address expert no I can understand the concept but again this deconcentration mu eta padhini mu kahibini mar mane paduni hatat I think you can search in your book in the Google and if still you are not finding it then I can help you you know finding what is the difference between the deconcentration and the centralization this public administration is a highly technical subject you know every term has its you know unique meaning right
yes
you can help me also because you also belong to public administration
yes, sir.
what is this deconcentration
means deconcentration means sir clogging work at headquarters or a central ministry can lead to the concentration of authority in like fact confusion in policy inputs role confusions among players delays in decision poor logistics
I want you to make us understand it. Now you are reading, right? Now what is yes, decentralization? We got a sense. This is what decentralization. Yeah. Both would aspect koi gali. But then how to understand deconcentration and how deconcentration is different from decentralization?
I think sir, deconcentration is availed, which is transfer of authority and functions to field units.
अच्छा आई थिंक कैन यू से दैट देयर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन डेलीगेशन एंड डीकंसंट्रेशन
यस सर
बट देन आई डाउट एक्चुअली इन पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन इफ देयर इज टू कांसेप्ट डेलीगेशन एंड डीकंसंट्रेशन देन मे बी देयर विल बी अ वेरी सटल डिफरेंस बिटवीन दिस टू टर्म बट देन टेल मी बिघ्नेश व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द डेलीगेशन एंड डीकंसंट्रेशन
deconcentration means it is availed with the transfer of authority and function to field units of within the central ministry
acha eta within the central ministry
okay
now I got a sense in delegation in delegation, it may also involve in the state ministry, right? In the state yes, administration.
Sir, within an organization and the form of government agency to the outside right. agencies.
But in deconcentration, this concept is related with the central ministry, right?
Yes, sir.
You are not concentrating right. the authority with you, rather than you are giving some authority to them. That's how you become you develop a deconcentration of authority. Ere kahin ki deconcentration kahin ki kora jaye?
For better reach and effectiveness work.
Same logic. Effectiveness and efficiency, right?
Yes, same yes, logic.
Je mu jodi beshi concentration koribi ta mu ba ko manage korini sethi pai I will give some of the power to my cabinet in that particular ministry, central ministry. So this concentration is related with the central ministry, I think so.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I will check a question. Jahari Behitiwa, he can also check in connection to our discussion. Then we check all Nishita me pay you. Okay, then. Thank you.
Okay, sir. धन्यवाद सर धन्यवाद हिमांशु शकर मिश्रा सर आज क्लास रे अति प्रांजल भाव आम विद्यार्थी मानक आप आज बुझे ओडिशा राज्य मुक्त विश्वविद्यालय तरफ आपण को अनेक अनेक धन्यवाद आज क्लास रे थिबा विद्यार्थी मानक अनेक अनेक धन्यवाद एवं आमर टेक्निकल टीम मेंबर मानक अनेक अनेक धन्यवाद
ओके थैंक यू वेरी मच